Can I welcome you all to this Tree of Light service? It's the first one we've held outside for over 2 years now. I don't know why Christmas occurs always on dark winter nights in December, but it does. And it's just beginning to rain to boot, so we apologize. And of course, we could have no timing for England playing in the football. But you might get home in time to see the second half. This is really, I hope, a service for everyone. Everyone who has had family or friends cared for at the hospice, but not just the hospice. It is for everyone who is here to remember someone who has died. In doing so, later this evening, we will light, I was going to say the tree, it's a mast. The powers that be took the two conifers down that were here 2 or 3 years ago, you may remember them. But I think it will look wonderful. They will be lit in memory towards the end of the service. I'm going to say thank you to everybody later, but I do note that the Salvation Army are able to play their instruments with their gloves on. I don't know quite how you do that. Everybody who is here tonight is important to us, but I would like to thank our Lord Lieutenant James Saunders Watson, who is here this evening, and our Mayor of Kettering, Kelly Watts. I did warn them to put extra clothing on, and I hope you all have this evening. So let us start with our first carol, Once in Royal David City.
Thank you.
Hear us, O loving Father, as we remember this night those whom we have placed in your hands. Enfold them in your love and enfold us too in your caring arms. Amen. Charles Wide is now going to come and read to us what is now a famous poem written by Michael Rosen. When I knew Michael, he was a first-year medical student with me at the Middlesex Hospital in London. Like all famous people, he changed his first name from Wayne to Michael and just lasted the year before he went off to read English at Wadham, I think. But this is now a poem that enshrines our thanks for everyone who works in the National Health Service in increasingly troubled times.
These are the hands by Michael Rosen. These are the hands that touch us first, feel your head, find the pulse, and make your bed. These are the hands that tap your back, test the skin, hold your arm, wheel the bin, change the bulb, fix the drip, pour the jug, replace your hip. These are the hands that fill the bath, mop the floor, flick the switch, soothe the sore, burn the swabs, give us a jab, throw out sharps, design the lab. And these are the hands that stop the leaks, empty the pan, wipe the pipes, carry the can, clamp the veins, make the cast, log the dose, and touch us last.
We will now hear Wellingborough Gospel Choir sing for us.
There's no peace, there's no faith if you don't believe. There are people doing wrong and yet seem strong. I don't need to tell you that this can go on.
Several years ago, I was wandering, as you do, through Kettering's town centre when I heard somebody playing the trumpet, and it was Adam Gregory, who's going to play for us now. I asked Adam what he was doing there. Well, he was obviously playing his trumpet, wasn't he? But he was busking, and he was busking his way through doing a PhD. I approached him and said, well, will you come and play for the hospice one night? Didn't tell him how cold and miserable it could be, but he's come ever since. So Adam will now play for us in the bleak midwinter. Going to light four candles that represent some of the emotions that accompany grief, some of the emotions that you may have felt in the past few weeks, months, or years. Grief, courage, love, and hope. And with each candle being lit, that will be accompanied by three poems and an extract from a letter. The first poem, which our Lord Lieutenant will read, is by Wendy Cope. She went to a neighbouring school to mine in Kent many, many years ago, but I think it does really express some of the emotions that we feel, especially at this time.
A Christmas Story by Wendy Cope. Why is the baby crying on this, his special day, when we have brought him lovely gifts and laid them on the hay? He's crying for the people who greet this day with dread, because somebody dear to them is far away or dead. For all the men and women whose love affairs went wrong, who tried their best at merriment when Christmas comes along. For separated parents whose turn it is to grieve, while children hang their stockings up elsewhere on Christmas Eve. For everyone whose burden carried through the year is heavier at Christmas time, the season of good cheer. That's why the baby's crying there in the cattle stall. He's crying for those people. He's crying for them all.
Rosalind, who's one of our Cransley Hospice nurses, is going to read an extract from a letter by Arthur Ashe to his daughter, Camera. For those of you who are younger than I am, you may not remember who Arthur Ashe was. He was a leading tennis player. I ought to know whether he won Wimbledon. I think he did. He developed later in life, in his 40s, heart problems. And at that time, things were not quite as refined as they were now. And he was given infected blood, became HIV positive, and sadly later died from AIDS. But he wanted to write something for his daughter. I think Camera was only 6 at the time, something that she should have by her for the rest of her life when he couldn't be there. It's such a well-written letter that it, I think, is helpful for all of us here tonight and for many, many thousands of people who know it and read it and keep it by their bedside all over the world.
A letter from Camera to Camera from her father, Arthur Ashe. Don't be angry with me if I'm not there in person. I would like nothing than to be with you always. Do not feel sorry for me. I loved you deeply, and you gave me so much happiness I can never repay you. Wherever I am, when you feel sick at heart and weary of life, or when you stumble and fall and don't know if you can get up again, think of me. I'll be watching and smiling and cheering you on.
The third piece that we will hear tonight is by the poet Adrian Mitchell. It's a strange title, as you will see from your programme, a bit daunting in a way, but once again it sums up experiences from his life that we can experience in our own.
Death is smaller than I thought, by Adrian Mitchell. When they died, my love for them did not vanish or fade away. It stayed just about the same, only a sadder colour. And I can feel their love for me, same as it ever was. Nowadays, in good times or in bad, I sometimes ask my mother and father to walk beside me or to sit with me so that we can talk together or be silent. They always come to me. I talk to them and I listen to them. And I think I hear them talk to me. It's very simple. Nothing to do with spiritualism or religion or mumbo jumbo. It is imaginary. It is real. It is love.
And finally, the chief executive of our charity, Philip Talbot, will read a poem by Hugo Williams. Hugo Williams is a poet that I've been reading for many years. You will hear him enfold, wrap us in one of his memories. And at the end, when he demonstrates how he is carrying on, how life is carrying on, perhaps unexpectedly, that hope is such an important thing that accompanies grief.
Now That I Hear Trains by Hugo Williams. Now that I hear trains whistling out of Paddington on the way to Wales, I like to think of him, as young as he was then, running behind me along the sand, holding my saddle steady and launching me off on my own. Now that I look, unlike the boy on the brand new bike who wobbled away down the beach, I hear him telling me, "Keep pedaling, keep pedaling." When I looked over my shoulder, he was nowhere to be seen.
We will now sing our second carol, While Shepherds Watch Their Flocks by Night. Thank you. I would like to invite the Mayor of Kettering, Councillor Kelly Watts, to turn the lights on, I was going to say our tree, on our mast, and then she's going to read for us.
We Will Remember Them by Sylvan Kremers and Jack Reimer. When we are weary and in need of strength, when we are lost and sick of heart, we will remember them. When we have a joy to crave and share, when we have decisions that are difficult to make, When we have achievements that are based on his or hers, we'll remember them. At the blueness of the skies and the warmth of the summer, at the rustling of leaves and in the beauty of the autumn, we will remember them. At the rising of the sun and its setting, we will remember them. At the opening of the buds and in the rebirth of spring, we will remember them. At the blowing of the wind and the chill of winter, we remember them. As we look upon the lights of remembrance, we remember them. As long as we live, they too will live, for they are now part of us. We remember them.
In the next few weeks, as you walk past or drive past carefully, I hope you'll look upon these lights and remember too. Thank you for donating for every light that's on our tree. It does look like a tree, doesn't it? It really is wonderful. While we look at the lights, I'd now like to invite Anna and Nicholas to sing O Holy Night.
Never ever pray.
gloved hands. We'll now hear Adam Gregory, who will play once more for us, and bring him home. Before I invite the gospel choir to sing once more for us, I would simply like to dedicate these lights. God of love and light, these lights acknowledge your love and light in us. In this brief moment, we ask for stillness and to be drawn to your love. Give strength to those for whom we pray. Give strength to all who are here tonight. We ask this in the light of your love. Amen.
I deserve it, a second chance.
test. I can't believe it. I've lost my pride. No more excuses, no place to hide. And now I stand alone. Will I ever know? Will I ever find the light?
Just let the shine. Ooh. You are the lighthouse in the storm. Just let the shine.
Thank you. We're drawing to a close now. A few thank yous before I let you go. A big thank you to our event sponsors, T. James, and to everyone who's taken part in this service tonight, the St. Mary's Hospital Estate team, everyone who's read, the Salvation Army Band, the Wellingborough Gospel Choir, Adam Gregory, who's driven all the way down from Bolton to be here with us this evening, Anna Gould and Nicholas Moody, who have sung for us, Kelly Watts, the Mayor of Kettering, who has switched on the lights and read for us, the Lord Lieutenant of Northamptonshire, James Saunders Watson, the Cooperative Funeral Directors for supplying tea and coffee and mince pies, and please have some at the end of the service. Jack Warwick, Funeral Directors for printing the service booklets for us, and DC Video and ATEC Events for filming tonight and for the sound system. It always amazes me how well it is done. We've come a long, long way from when we had a 6-foot Christmas tree in the hospice garden well over 20 years ago now. I think the tree was bought from Kettering Market when there was such a thing, and it had a few lights on, and there were perhaps 10, 15 or 20 of us gathered round the tree. The event has grown, the hospice has grown. But we're here tonight for you all. Thank you for supporting us. And my prayer is that we will continue to support you, your families, and your friends over the coming weeks, months, and years. I'd almost forgotten, because I'd meant to put them in, mention them earlier. They give me a list of thank yous for me to remind me. But the members of our Cransley Hospice Trust team never thank themselves, and to put on this Tree of Light service doesn't just happen. There's an awful lot of work that they've done over the last few weeks and months, so I would really like to thank them too. Go home safely. Have a truly happy and, I hope, peaceful Christmas. God bless you all. Thank you. ¶¶